So today we'll discuss one topic from thermal properties of matter, that is Newton's law of cooling. So here Newton told that if there is a temperature difference between the object and the surrounding, then the temperature difference will be directly proportional to the rate of the cooling, or rate of the cooling is directly proportional to the temperature difference. That means more will be the temperature difference, and the faster will be the cooling. What does that mean? That means suppose a cup of tea is there. So the temperature of the cup, hot tea, is more, and the surrounding temperature is, suppose, let's say 27 degree, and the tea temperature, hot tea temperature, is, let's say, it's approximately 95 degree or 100 degree centigrade. So this difference is more. But if I bring a normal, slightly hot water, then suppose 50 degree or 60 degree, then the temperature difference is less. So Newton experimentally verified, and also he theoretically told that the rate of cooling, that is minus dq by dt equal to, is proportional to a temperature difference. The temperature difference T1 we have considered here as surrounding temperature, or almost constant temperature. Surrounding temperature. Okay. And T2 is the temperature of the object. Now, I can write this by negative sign. I have given a negative sign because the cooling loss is being met. So a negative sign here indicates that it's a, means decrease, means there is a loss of heat. Okay. So if there is some temperature difference, then more is the temperature difference, more faster this dq upon dt, this will give you that how fast the heat is dissipated, or how fast the cooling is taking place. So more is the temperature difference, more will be the rate of loss. Here this T and this T are different. This T represents your temperature, but this T is rate, means time. Okay. Q represents your heat. How fast the heat is, how fast the object is losing the, or cooling down, losing the heat. So I can write that minus dq by dt equal to k T2 minus T1, right? So T2 minus T1. Okay, I have taken one constant, proportionality constant, you can think of. Now, I also know that from the concept of heat capacity, that I can write that your specific or heat capacity is your dq upon dq by dt2. Okay, dq by dt2, this is your specific heat capacity, 1 by m. This is your specific heat capacity. What is specific heat capacity? Now, the amount of heat required to raise the temperature or cool that object, okay, either absorbing or dissipating. Okay, so the amount of heat required to increase or decrease a unit temperature of an object of unit mass, this is called specific heat. So S is equal to 1 by m dq by dt2. because dT2 is the temperature of the object. So here cooling is taking place. So dQ, T2 I have taken, means a change is taking place at the temperature T2, not T1. So I can write that dQ is equal to SML cross multiply dT2. Okay. Or if I differentiate both sides with respect to time, dQ upon dT, this is the rate of cooling, you can say. So SM dT2 by dT. I can write, no problem. Now if I write minus, then it will become minus. Okay. Now you can see the left hand side of equation, let's say this is equation one, this is equation two. The left hand side of equation one and two are equal. So I can write that your minus SM from one and two, I can write that from one and two, I can write minus SM dT2 dT is equal to KT2 minus T1. Now I'll separate the variables. Okay. I'll bring your temperature, near temperature, and time I'll take to the right side. So I'll write like this. dT2 is, I'll bring here, this T2 minus T1. And this one I'll take here, minus K upon SM. S is the specific heat capacity. Mass is the M, the mass of the substance. Is dT, right? Now, what I'll do, I'll integrate both sides, right? And K by SM, all are constants. So I'll introduce a new constant, okay? I'll introduce a new constant for that. And so I'll integrate both sides. And this is constant, so I'll integrate both sides. Integrating both sides, what is the result I am getting? The result I am getting, this is, you can say, T2 and T1, we are considering it's approximately constant. Okay. So like it's like dx by x minus 2 or x minus any constant. So integration will be ln e or log base e, ln x2 minus x1, x minus k constant, right? So what derivative of 1 upon x dx is log x, and you can use a substitution, you will get this okay, same thing. Take x minus t, 2 is equal to another variable, you take, use a substitution one, substitution technique to find out the derivative. So you can easily find out that is, it is in the form of dx upon x, because this constant will not create any problem for us. So similarly, here the integration will be log base e, T2 minus T1, as I have told you, T1 we have considered as a surrounding temperature. So it's almost constant. Surrounding temperature does not change easily. So it's a constant. And minus, let's say this is, I am taking as C, one more constant. Okay. Or this constant, let me write, this is A. And derivative integration of dT, you can write as T plus one more constant will come, C. Now, one more technique I'll use. If logarithm is there, then if I remove this logarithm from the left side, I have to write e to the power. Suppose log x is equal to z, then I can write x is equal to e to the power z. Okay, I can do that because it will not change the value ln base e. Okay, so here I'll remove log and I'll write in the form of e. So this is what I got exactly, my expression. Okay, now I'll just try to write it in the form of e. So I'll write, this is implied that T2 minus T1, this is the temperature difference. Okay, and it will come e to the power minus 80 plus c. So something power, okay, if I write x to the power a plus b, then I can write x to the power a multiplied by x to the power b. This is the basic algebra, you know. So here I'll also separate the variable and I can write it in a good form, that I can write T2 is equal to T1, I'll take to the right side, T1 plus, and this one I can write e to the power c is a constant. So e to the power 8 minus 80 into e to the power c, that I'll write e to the power c into e to the power minus 80. For a, you know, a I have taken as k upon sm. Okay, k upon sm I have taken as the constant a. Okay, s is the specific heat, m is the mass, k is the proportionality constant at the beginning we have taken. So here, as you can see, T2 is equal to T1 plus e to the power c minus 80. So this is your equation. The temperature T2 of the object will be equal to T1 plus e to the power c into e to the power minus 80. Now, if you draw a graph, then how does this graph will look like? Experimentally, it is also verified that if you draw a graph of this one, taking in the y-axis log base e, T2 minus T1, and in the x-axis, it will take your time, this is the temperature difference, you will get a graph like this, that when the time is increasing, the temperature difference is gradually falling down. Okay, so the graph will look like this. Okay, and this is the expression for your Newton's law of cooling, and experimentally also you can verify this experiment is also there in your class 11 practical. So in some institute, some schools, they perform this Newton's law of cooling experiment, and they verify whether if the temperature difference is there, then how fast, or if they are obeying this rule or not, how fast they are cooling down. If there is more difference in temperature between the two, T2 minus T1, then the fasting will, means rate of losing cooling down will be faster than if T2 minus T1 is small. Okay, so I hope you are clear on the derivation. If you have find any difficulties in the derivation, you can write in the comment box so I can explain you in another video. And I think in the next video I'll discuss some more, or if possible I'll solve some problems based on the Newton's law of cooling. Okay, so for this video, let's stop here. Bye bye. See you in the next video.